Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be creating Softbubbles graphic design. We'll use Ellipse tool to create all the circles and use layer style options to add a drop shadow and 3D depth. So let's begin with the tutorial. Open a new Photoshop document. Firstly, we'll add a background color. So unlock the layer and choose gradient tool. Open the gradient editor panel, double click on the right slider and change the color to light pink. For the left slider, change the color to a little dark pink. You can apply the same values as shown on the color picker panel, then click OK. Now using the gradient panel, click and drag to apply the color diagonally. Next, add a new layer. For this, we'll apply lighter gradient color tone. So open the gradient editor panel and change right slider color to lighter color. Do the same for the other slider and click OK. Now click and drag to apply the color using the gradient tool. It will be applied on the new layer. Next, select the eraser tool and change the brush type to sharp brush. Increase the size and just click to erase a portion. We'll erase few more regions to create circular holes. Reduce the size while creating the other two holes. So we got a background layer and a holo layer on the top. Now we'll apply some layer style. So double click on the layer to open the layer style panel. Here, first we'll add a drop shadow. Change the drop shadow color to the shade of pink. Set the angle to 82 degrees. Size to 54 pixels. Distance to 30 pixels. And the opacity to 64%. And we got a nice shadow effect. Next, apply bevel and ambers. Here, change the color to pink. Uncheck use global light and change the angle to 34 degrees. Size to 3 pixels, softness to 5 pixels, and the depth value to 115%. Then click OK. We can see a nice depth between the two layers. Now we'll give a small cut on the top layer. So select the eraser tool and with a smaller brush size, give a straight cut between the two circles. Let's do some adjustments on the layer style panel. Change the angle of rotation to 114 degrees and the opacity to 66%. Now we'll create circular soft bubbles using the ellipse tool. So select the ellipse tool and draw a circle. Remove the stroke color and under fill color, choose the gradient color. Double click on the left slider to open the color picker panel. Choose a color with a little reddish tone added to it. For the right slider, choose light pink color. Change the angle of rotation to 16 degrees and place it around here. Next, with the Alt pressed, just click and drag to create a duplicate. Open the fill color and add a pink tone to the right slider and slight change on the left slider. Now let's add some drop shadow. So double click on the ellipse layer to open the layer style panel. Tick drop shadow. Change the shadow color to the shade of pink. Size to 18 pixels. Distance to 11 pixels and the opacity to 24%. Next, take bevel and ambers. Here again, change the color. Uncheck use global light and change the angle of rotation to minus 13 degrees. Set the depth value to 95%, size to 2 pixels and the softness to 7 pixels. In the same way, we'll apply the layer style to the other circles with a slight variation in the values. Duplicate few more circles of different sizes, place them in a proper order. Next step is, we have to adjust the gradient of each and every circles. So select individual circles, adjust the gradient using the color pickers and the bevel and ambers under layer style panel. We'll give different shades of color to the individual circles and apply few ellipse with the darker shades. Next, we'll modify the shape of few of the ellipse. So select the circle and use Command or Control D to transform. Then right click and choose distort option. Now distort the shapes to give a dynamic look. Do this for few of the circles. This will create a sense of depth as well as natural look. Adjust all the effects and style for the last time. Now add a new layer on the top. Apply light pink color. Then go to Effect, Noise, Add Noise. Set the noise amount to 11% and click OK. After that, change the layer mode to Multiply and reduce the opacity around 67%. This will add a nice texture to the design. Next, add a brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Set the contrast value to 3 and the brightness value to 18. Then add an exposure adjustment layer. Here, set the offset value to -0.0729 and the exposure to +0.14. Then add a hue and saturation adjustment layer to reduce the saturation value. We'll give around -21. Draw a line using the brush tool. Duplicate them to create a diagonal grid. We can also get a fresh color tone by adjusting the hue values. Lastly, type out a text and choose a nice font for the design. Finally, we have completed designing Softbubbles design. During this process, we have understood the use of layer style effects. We have also understood how we can create a dynamic design using very few options. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you have more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.